honest, how do you do that in the studio? No, I'm serious, bro. Like, I cannot... I go to sleep trying to figure that out. I am not joking.
That's probably where you should concentrate, because the only way you can really evolve forward, I think, is to clean out the closet, do the spring cleaning.
What's going on, everybody? We're back with another segment of Rappers React. Smoke diggity dog.
What up?
If you have 1 foot over your other foot, and your toes were lined up perfectly, what would you call the one on the bottom?
Bert and Ernie. Mr. Rogers. What about the Undertow?
You got it, my friend. Guys, before we get started, please do us a big favor, y'all. Please hit that thumbs up button. Guys, please subscribe to the channel.
And for God's sake, leave us a comment. Tell us what to react to next, because that's how we get the ideas for these videos. Comes directly from you, right down in the comment section. And today, being...
That was a smooth today. All right, my fault. Go ahead.
Being Tool Tuesday, we shall open our books of Tool and read another chapter.
Yes. Everyone, open your book of Tool and let's read from the chapter Undertow.
Undertow.
You know what, Smokey? This is a chapter.
Dang it.
That is not only a chapter, but an entire book in the book of Tool. Yes.
Undertow. Undertow.
Undertow.
All right. Early Tool work. Some of your favorite.
Yes.
Are we going to get some potato soup today?
Oh, man. I'm hoping we get some chunky.
Man, dude. Some
chunky like a monkey, man.
You know, it's kind of... I'm starting to think, how did we not get to this song sooner? Because going through the Undertow album, you know, with all the great songs that album has...
Yeah, you would think we got to get to the title track right away, right?
Right. But. All right, let me speak for a second. As an artist, I've never understood title tracks. I've never understood that.
Why?
I don't know. To me, it's like, okay, I'm Hollywood 6. I got an album coming out called Hollywood 6, and my hit song is called Hollywood 6.
Well, that's a little different. But if you have an album called, you know, The Life of Hollywood 6.
Right.
And, you know, and the first track is called The Life of Hollywood 6.
Okay,
you
know, I get that.
I mean, well, I'm trying to think.
We
covered one. It was the band, the album, and the song. The song was all the same name. I'm trying to think of what it was. I can't think of it right offhand.
Was it Halloween?
Well, there was Halloween. No, that wasn't it, though.
Well, I'm sure why he's thinking about it, but yeah. I don't know. I mean, in hip hop, again, coming from the mind of a rap artist, looking at a self-titled track as a hip hop artist in hip hop, I think that's lazy. But I'm not speaking about progressive. I'm not speaking about metal. I'm not speaking about any other genre. I'm specifically talking about hip hop. I think that's lazy.
Well, I must be lazy because I did that.
I know you've done it. I don't know. It's just me. You can hate me for it, but I don't know why. It's like, okay, if your album is called, you know, Big Boats and Boobs, why do you have a self-titled track called Big Boats and Boobs?
Well, mine would, when I do it, it would be the intro song.
So what was yours? Let me see.
Like, I had an album called Can't Stop Me Now.
See, that's kind of, I understand that.
Yeah, so I had a song. Or sometimes I think, you know, artists will, especially it seems like it happened more back in the day, that you would have your biggest hit and you just, rather than giving it a unique name, you would just name the album after the hit rather than making a song named after the album.
Okay, didn't you have an album Lessons of Aggression?
Yes.
Okay, so
and the intro track was Lessons of Aggression.
That's what I thought. All right, now with Tool having Undertow, and the song being called Undertow. See, now I want to know the track listing. Is this number one on that album? Is Undertow the first song on Undertow?
Yeah, that would make a lot of sense if it was.
And if it is the first song off of Undertow, does this song kind of tell you, hey, this is what Undertow is going to be? If it's track number one. I don't know if this is track number one or not.
Yeah, I have no clue, but that wouldn't make sense, you know? I mean, just coming from our standpoint, that would make sense, you know?
Right.
But then again, I had an album, that same album, Can't Stop Me Now, where I kept that theme up through the entire album.
Right.
You know?
See, man, Tool's, they're so intricate, man, and it's hard to... And we're not comparing what we do at all.
No, not at all.
Not at all. But we're I'm just trying to figure out this title track thing. But now, maybe Tool is going to change my mind and be like, hey, this is why we did it. This is how we did it.
Yeah.
And this is how it's done.
It's very possible.
Smoke up.
What up?
Let's get into it.
Let's do it. Oh. Oh.
Dude.
Yeah.
That early bass.
Dude, that is awesome. How do you do that?
mind blowing. Oh man! How? Bro, listen, hold on. Oh man. Alright. Okay. Crawl Away. You remember listening to Crawl Away?
Yeah.
Okay. I kinda got a similar vibe. Mm-hmm. However, Maynard, yes, the lyrics are there. But okay, man,
Danny. Oh, there was something special happening. No, with the drum work.
The drum. And, no, yeah, the guitar work.
The guitar is riding on the drums.
That burner, burner. Dude, I real serious question, y'all. I know I've asked this, but honestly, how do you do that in the studio? No, I'm serious, bro. Like, I cannot. I go to sleep trying to figure that out. I am not joking. How do they do that? How do you? So how does the guitarist come in and know?
The only way I could picture it is they have to lay out the drums first,
which they've said.
Yes, and then you come back in and you have to almost memorize those drum patterns before you can go ahead and lay down your guitar work. That's the only way I can see it.
I would pay money. I would pay anything to just be in the studio and see how that is done.
Because as we've seen in progressive, like, it's so intricate and so hard. Like, you really have to memorize it. I don't know any other way.
How would you? I mean, straight up, like, you know, at the part where he was like, where it was just going smooth, flowing fine, and then you got don't.
Unless they laid it down piece by piece, like, you know, he records four bars and then go back. Okay, what's the next four bars gonna do? And then he lays down the part.
That's crazy.
If you're gonna go through and lay the whole song out like your guitar work, you're gonna do it through the whole song,
right?
Like all in one cut,
dude.
Then you're gonna have to memorize that drum pattern. That's crazy.
Taking what you said, if they did do that by four bars, you know how long it would take to make that
long
song? Dude. Because Tool, they have your 3, 4, 5, 6 minute songs, but they also have your 13, 14, 15 minute songs.
Yeah, exactly.
So if they did that to where, you know, every four bars, all right, Danny comes in. Here's my four bars. All right, now Adam has come in. All right, let me memorize Danny's. Okay, cool. All right, here's my four bars. Bam. All right, I'm Adam, Danny, done. Justin, go ahead. Justin, all right, let me memorize it. All right, cool. Maynard comes in 4 weeks later, puts his lyrics on. Yeah. Then Danny, Adam, and Justin have already redid something and sent it back to him. I've actually heard that before.
Yeah.
I've heard that Maynard, that they have sent a song to Maynard.
Yeah, here's the entire instrumental, and you work on your lyrics over this.
Right. And then Maynard gets it back, and then they switch up. It's a whole different song.
Yeah.
Like,
well, and think about this. As with most other genres, you know, excluding rap and probably some industrial and techno, things like that, that's going to use electronic music. If you just the typical old school rock song, you know, you're going to have, it's going to start off, you're going to have your intro, and then you got an 8-bar hook or a 4-bar hook, depending on whatever you're using. And then you have a 16 or an 8, a 12, or a 16-bar verse.
Mm-hmm.
And then you want a bridge and then a hook, you know, and they're all laid out. Whereas the guitarist could come in and knows that, you know, okay, right, we're doing, you know, 4-bar hook and then an 8-bar verse and then a 4-bar hook.
He can play over that bridge without having to hear
it. Yeah, exactly.
Right.
Like, you can just memorize it because it's so easy. But with prog, like, all that's out the window.
No. And I'm sorry, this may seem like nerd talk to some people who don't know what we're talking about, but it just baffles me how they come up with their music. I mean, seriously. Yeah.
It's intricate, man. That's the only thing you can use to describe it. It's just intricate.
God, dude, I'm serious when I say that there is, from what I've heard, there is not another band like Tool. From what I've heard.
Well, not at all. I mean, not that I've ever heard.
That
I
incorporates
mean, we've heard other prog bands before, but Tool is just, they're in a category by themselves, man.
Man,
it's the whole thing. I mean, it's just musical genius all around.
You're right. All right, look, we can talk about the way they make. Let's talk about the song for a second. All right, now, two things I want to say before I open my book of Tool and dissect some of these lyrics. Maynard, when he, it sounds like he says things. It sounds like he can go say it easily. Like he could say, like when he was saying "shut up, shut up." Mm-hmm. He, I feel like if he's in the studio, he's just in front of the mic saying it calm, standing still. Shut up, but he's putting so much power. You know what I'm saying?
You
like,
gotta move.
Right. Most people would be like, "Shut up, shut up, shut up." Yeah. But I feel like he's just standing. Shut up, shut up, shut up. You know what I mean? He's putting. Yeah. He doesn't have to put all that movement into that.
Well, as we saw with the one live video that we did was sober.
Right.
We saw him like he was in that hunched over position. Yeah, and he wasn't really thrashing about, you know. He was belting that out from that one hunched over position.
You know how hard that is to do?
Yeah. Oh, I know. It's crazy. I mean,
I'm sorry, guys. Dang it. Pool's got me all flustered today, dude. I'm just all over the place, man. Opening my book of Tool. All right. I'm kind of confused here because mm-hmm. I'm thinking this could be about three things, man. Mm-hmm. This could either be about drugs.
Mm-hmm.
This could either be about Satan or some evil entity.
Yeah.
Or it could be just an inner voice of himself.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the part that sticks out to me as I open my book of Tool, he says, all right, shut up. Okay, well, first, the first line is, two times in, I've been struck dumb by a voice that speaks from deep. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's the first thing. I'm like, okay, maybe he's talking about himself. Maybe he's talking about something that's calling him. Mm-hmm. But later on in the song, he's saying, shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up. You're saturating me. How could I let this bring me back to my knees third time in? This is what makes me think he might be talking about Satan or some evil entity. I've been baptized by a voice that screams from deep beneath the cold black water. It's half as high as heaven, half as clear as reason, cold and black like silt on the riverbed.
Mm-hmm.
So, to the Tool army out there, I need an explanation.
Yeah.
What do you got?
The only thing it sounds like drugs to me, man.
Drugs.
It does. I mean, I can see what you're saying, you know, and I see why you're saying that. But that's what it sounds like to me. It sounds like drugs, man. Because, you know, and especially where the part who he was talking about euphoria, you know.
Uh-huh.
And, yeah, and it keeps pulling him in, you know. Think about it. Drugs is the thing that it can make you feel like you're in heaven and hell all in the same day.
Yeah.
You know.
See, I don't think Maynard...
I don't know. I mean, I don't know that he has ever been, you know, on any kind of real explicit drugs. I mean, other than hallucinogens or whatever he's done.
Right.
You know, I don't know. But that's what it sounds like to me, just from the lyrics that, I mean, you know, that I've picked out of it.
Right. You could be right, man. And something Maynard's good with is speaking from the perspective of another person.
Yeah. I mean, it could be, it may not be something he went through himself. Could be something that somebody else went through and he just saw it, you know.
Right. Huh. I don't know, man. I'm honestly confused by this one.
But like I've said before, you know, you really don't want to write songs that you haven't experienced, because you will experience.
Yeah.
All you gotta do is write it, and it's gonna happen eventually.
Dude, that is so freaking true. If you want something to happen, write it down.
Yeah.
Or speak it. Write it or speak it. It's gonna happen.
You speak it into existence. Yeah.
The law of
happens
attraction.
All the time.
Man, but what I was saying about, you know, the title tracks, now hearing this, see, I was ignorant to the fact of thinking, you know, hip-hop, I was speaking of the perspective from hip-hop, like saying, you know, it was, when hip-hop artists do it, it doesn't make sense to me, unless it explains the album.
Mm-hmm.
Now, with this, it explains... From what I've heard from Undertow, this sounds like
what the Undertow
exactly.
is.
Exactly. This sounds like every step of Undertow that it's going to take you through.
Exactly.
So I get it. Thank you.
Yeah. And we were talking earlier, you know, it doesn't. Yeah, it is kind of lazy if you, you know, you just made a hit song and it's like number 5 on the album. And, you know, it's At the Club, you know, is the name of the song. You're just, okay, well, my album is At the Club because I'm trying to make that a hit. Yeah, that is kind of lazy.
That's lazy.
But it's another thing if you use it to explain what the album is about.
Right. It could be used as a marketing tool. Mm-hmm. I get it. Man, Tuesday has done it again. I will say on this particular Tool Tuesday, I'm going to need some explanation from the subscribers out there. Please, guys, if there's a definition or definitive thing that Maynard or Adam, Justin, Paul, anybody has said as to what the lyrics or what the song's about, mm-hmm. let us know.
Yeah, I'm waiting to see that.
I agree, guys. Definitely. Thank y'all so much. Any more suggestions, please keep them coming because we're definitely going to get through the whole catalog. And with that being said, my name is Behringer Hollywood. Six Bonds.
I forgot my name. Smokey Ramirez Cowan.
And we are
over
and
out. Deuces. I want to thank you guys for tuning in to Tool Tuesdays, one of our new favorite artists and possibly the greatest band on earth. If you want to see more Tool, just click right over here in this area. If you want to see another artist that we cover, just click right over here and you'll be on to that. And I want to thank you guys. Please subscribe to the channel and give us a thumbs up. It really helps the algorithm a lot. We'll see you next time.